that women of the state of Louisiana are and is her backbone. A direct attack at every woman in the city of New Orleans and around the state of Louisiana. The threats, I didn't take them lightly at all, and I know that women and even young women, you know, that I speak to feel violated. Our reproductive care should only be in our hands. And as we consult with our physicians about the best care for our bodies, for ourselves, for our lives, we matter. And so it was a slight at, again, the backbone of the state of Louisiana and absolutely that of the city of New Orleans.
Are you nervous that doctors, nurses, anyone who works in healthcare may want to leave Louisiana following this decision?
I think that people in service are under attack, and our healthcare professionals, our physicians, are part of that category as well. I think that this ruling, these laws, definitely worsen patient care, but absolutely those that we depend on to render that care, and those are physicians in the state of Louisiana. It will have an impact. I'm hearing just that.
What will the impact of this have specifically in New Orleans? You know, I had mentioned to the Attorney General, no abortions means more babies, more pregnant mothers in need. What will this mean specifically to New Orleans and the city?
Specifically to New Orleans, which is majority African American. A large portion of that are black women. What it means is that this population will continue to be the most vulnerable in regards to having care, reproductive care, that impacts that woman, that family, the community, the city overall. What it means is that the health care that will be rendered will be substandard. And so that gives me a great concern and calls for concern about the overall public health of our community and of our city, in which black women are the backbones of this city. It puts us all in jeopardy. My message, quite frankly, is that the city of New Orleans will take every step possible to safeguard our women, to ensure that the city of New Orleans is a safe haven, not only for women in Orleans Parish, but for women across the state of Louisiana. My director of public health, my health director, Dr. Vegno, and myself will be writing an official letter to the secretary of the Department of Health and Human Services to get the clarity that we need based on how the feds will help us locally to safeguard the care of women as best that we can. We're wanting to make sure that contraceptives and emergency contraceptives are made available to women in our community. We're wanting to make sure that we organize and galvanize the voices of stakeholders across this city and across this state to create that safe haven that we know that we will need now more than ever before. The state of Louisiana is at the bottom in terms of rendering care for women, and even that strongly of black women. So we're gonna do everything necessary within our power to create that safe haven and to meet our women where they are throughout this city, and making available the tools and resources and educational resources and even emergency contraceptives at every public space that we can, like our libraries, for example. And so we're just focused on that and doing the best that we can to provide that safe haven for women and young women.
And Mayor Cantrell, so currently the DA and the sheriff also have said they won't be going after people that are performing abortions or getting abortions. Can the Attorney General still come in and prosecute people that are getting abortions?
You know, what I do know and really what I'm proud of is the unified approach and focus on this issue locally, that we've stood up with that unified message about how we will protect women in our city, from the sheriff, the DA, the New Orleans City Council, my superintendent of police, and myself. We're unified, and even the judge who rendered the stay, even for a short period of time. And so we're going to do everything that we can to provide that safe haven in our community, and we'll stand tall against anyone who comes against women in the city of New Orleans and even that of the state of Louisiana. Our future depends upon it.
And does it give the message, though, that you can come to New Orleans and have an abortion, just to make sure people understand the stance?
Well, right now in the state of Louisiana, it's prohibited. And so the city of New Orleans, we are law abiding in our parish, no doubt about it. We stand for that. But we stand for justice, and we stand for care and rendering that care the best that we can. And so from that perspective, we're going to ensure that we provide education, resources, that we provide emergency contraceptives, that we provide that voice standing firm on women and providing the support that they need every step of the way. But at the end of the day, it is truly wanting them to have the best care possible so that they can continue to make the best decisions for themselves in spite of this law that just damages their lives and takes their right to their freedoms of reproductive care away. But we're wanting to safeguard them as best that we can. The fight isn't over. It cannot be over. Our future depends upon it. And so we're going to remain steadfast and strong and firm and stand up for what we know we believe in, but at the end of the day, do what we know is right according to the laws that we do have to follow.
So it seems that for right now, you have to follow the laws for right now.
For right now, that's what we have to do. However, we will keep women our priority and ensure that we're giving them the tools and information and providing that the contraceptives based on what we can so that they can ensure that they are rendered the best care possible. Even making sure, again, creating the safe haven in our city and in our state is something that is necessary right now more than ever. Well, it's bigger than abortion. It's about women's health and reproductive care, no doubt about it. And it's about public health, which is also about public safety. So that's what this is about.
There are people that say when it comes to crime, the city has lost control. Do you feel the city's lost control when it comes to crime?
So as it relates to public safety, in regards to the city's response to it, lost control? Absolutely not. A city that I lead, that I manage and oversee, a police department that has rendered over 484 felony arrests in the past month isn't one that has lost control. It's one that has stood up for accountability. And what I will say is that what we need to make sure is that the criminal justice system needs to function at its best to ensure that accountability is across the board and that those who are arrested on felony charges are held accountable and kept off the streets of the city of New Orleans. So as it relates to my focus, public safety remains that top priority, and I'm committed to working with every agency that has responsibility of rendering justice and ensuring that individuals that want to render harm on the streets of the city of New Orleans are held accountable and off of our streets. So that's following the lead that the New Orleans Police Department have set with getting individuals off the street. And so we're wanting to keep them off the street, and that just doesn't rest with the New Orleans Police Department, nor me as mayor, but it does rest with the system working collaboratively, and I'm committed to ensuring that it does that to the best of my ability. But accountability is across the board, also public responsibility. So we will continue to engage as a police department. We will continue to focus on preventative actions as a city, and we will continue to intervene as necessary And that is not only from a law enforcement perspective, but a holistic approach to fighting crime in our city and ensuring that we address the root causes, and which we're doing as a city, the best that we've done ever before. Over $40 million has gone into our families in terms of youth and preventative measures. And so that holistic approach is what we need to ensure that we render a city that comes out as being the safe that it's ever been. And so from my perspective and as mayor of the city, I refuse to look at this through one lens. It has to be a holistic approach, and that's what we're rendering on the streets of the city of New Orleans from NOPD and looking at the DA, the judges, and our entire system to function that bends toward accountability, keeping these violent offenders off of the streets. And NOPD's work, I'm proud of, and that 484 arrests is higher than we've seen since 2019, and we're gonna keep moving in the right direction.
There are people that are saying they're closing their businesses and they're wanting to leave New Orleans. How concerned are you about people making those actions?
So leaving the city of New Orleans doesn't help the city of New Orleans. So it depends on the people who are here and who are going to stay here and who are resilient, as they've demonstrated time and time and time again. The homicides in the city of New Orleans are those that are rooted in relationships. Hurt people hurt people. They are not random at all. They are ones of domestic violence. They are ones rooted in mental health, substance abuse, and they are ones that we're seeing time and time again across not only this city, but the United States of America, particularly throughout this pandemic. Trauma is real, and therefore, hurt people are hurting people in our community, in our families, and in our neighborhoods. There's no doubt about that. It's focusing also on the acts that are not random, or acts that are random in terms of carjackings, in terms of armed robberies. And there, those felony arrests, 484, cut at the bow of those random acts. And we're seeing results based on our 12-hour shifts that have resulted in more visibility, that have resulted in more arrest, felony charges across our city. So that is something that we should not only be proud of, but ensure that we keep engaging as the NOPD is doing. And so we need to turn to accountability that ensures that these individuals are kept off of the streets of the city of New Orleans. But the acts that are not random are absolutely rooted in individuals not being able to maintain their emotions as well as controlling themselves, stepping outside of how they have to not be able to de-escalate, but only to step over and cause bodily harm to people. Those are acts that we're seeing throughout the city of New Orleans, again, that are not random, that are rooted in trauma, and that are rooted in the fact that hurt people hurt people. And so getting to the root causes is what we're called to do in the city if we're wanting to turn it around, and we do want to turn it around, and that's where we're putting resources there, and that's where we're advocating for additional resources and tools to help not only the New Orleans Police Department, but to help individuals in our community de-escalate, to ensure that we have alternative dispatch to what we're seeing in our community relative to mental illness, substance abuse that we're seeing. But make no mistake about it, the homicides that you're referencing, the majority of them are people who know people. And it's the same population of people that it will either be the perpetrator and or the victim. So we know where to focus, and we are focusing right there. But this is about the people who care about the city of New Orleans, who are willing to pull up and roll up their sleeves to do everything that they can. If they see something, they say something. If they need to intervene, they do. If they need to even volunteer to be on a jury, this is something that they can do. So there is so much that we can do as a community, but leaving is not one of them if we're really serious about the care of our people and the care and the future of the city of New Orleans. I have to focus on the people who are staying here, not those that who feel that leaving is going to solve the problem, because it's not. It's happening everywhere, but it's about what's happening in the city of New Orleans that should trigger our response to action and care, and that's what I'm focusing on.
What would be your message to anyone with these approval ratings? What would be your message to anyone who's given you a low approval rating?
Sure. So the most recent approval rating, to my knowledge, was a comprehensive approval, a comprehensive rating on elected officials throughout the city of New Orleans. And so as I look at that, I say, and as I have said, the public deserves their elected officials to work together to solve challenges and problems and crises that we're faced with and that we're going through. I agree with that 100%. And I do believe that what the public has been receiving is not a unified approach at all. But from my perspective and from the leadership that I'm providing, it is comprehensive, it is laser focused on a collaborative process and a collaborative manner of ensuring that not only the city is safe, but that it stays safe. And public safety is also rooted in public health. And we've demonstrated that. And I've demonstrated that time and time again, and I will continue to, as best to my ability, to ensure that I'm on the ground, that I'm listening, that I care, and that I'm holding the people that work for me in this capacity, holding them accountable to rendering the best service possible by meeting people where they are. And that's what we're doing, but we cannot do it alone. And that's what I'm hearing from the public in terms of their ratings. They're looking for all of their elected officials to work together. And I agree with them on that. And so from that perspective, I'm saying to them, I am committed to working with anyone and everyone that cares about the health and public safety of the city of New Orleans, but I am not going to be baited in political showmanship and maneuvering, because at the end of the day, what this has shown to me is that people want us to work together, and when you want to take a shot at one branch of government, you know what? No one wins. And at the end of the day, you know who doesn't win? It's the people that I know that I took an oath to serve. They lose, and I'm not here for anybody to lose. And so I'm going to work tirelessly to ensure that the health of this community that's rooted in public safety advances for the future of this city. And I'm committed to that.
Do you feel safe in New Orleans currently?
I feel safe in the city of New Orleans, absolutely. But are there challenges? Are there individuals in our city that want to advance and wreak havoc and cause disturbances, as well as this uptick in violent crime and to cause harm in our community? You know, I'm seeing that, absolutely. I'm seeing that hurt people in our community. And so does that give me concern? Yes, it does. But it doesn't force me to give up. I'm hopeful because it's so many people in this community that do care about our children, that do care about our people who are suffering from mental health, that do care about trauma that our people are faced with, and that are rooted in really rendering decisions to make it better. And so I'm going to stay on that line. I'm going to stay on the battlefield with those who have taken that same oath of office, like our New Orleans police officers that are sworn to protect and serve, and leave it all on the line. And we're going to continue to fight for the city of New Orleans. It seems to be an uphill battle, but we're fighting and we're seeing the results. We're moving in the right direction, and I'm hopeful. Sure, yes, gas prices are hurting the city of New Orleans. Inflation across the board is hurting the city of New Orleans. And it's going to continue to force us to make tough decisions and prioritize our decisions, you know, as we make them in our city. The trifecta is real. Inflation, supply chain, human capital, it's a factor. And now we're seeing an uptick in COVID numbers that are demonstrating that it's having an impact on workforce. We're seeing an uptick on public safety from EMS to police and fire. We're seeing that. And we are staying vigilant. We are ensuring, you know, our folks are masking up. We're taking the necessary precautions. But it's about, you know, public safety and public health. And yes, inflation is having an impact on the city of New Orleans, from gas to milk to construction.
You brought up COVID. Do you anticipate any changes with the day-to-day operations of the city or with guidelines because of the state of the pandemic currently?
So right now, we continue to look at the levels, which are high. We're looking at our hospitalizations. We're looking at the impact on workforce. And what it's triggered for us is just to stay focused on pushing vaccinations. And I'm very proud, again, about our rate of vax in our city and boosters. We wanted to continue to push that. And also masking. It works. And so that's where we are right now. And to just push for people to be vigilant and aware and of their surroundings and mask up when they're in large crowds and in large gatherings in indoor environments. That's what we are asking our residents to do. The vaccines are the way.
The biggest takeaway that people, there might any misconceptions or anything else you wanted to add?
Well, I think that, you know, it's just, I want the public, I want our people to be hopeful, to understand that they play a role in ensuring that the city of New Orleans is safe, that we all have a responsibility, that me as mayor, I'm taking mine very seriously, that it is absolutely a holistic approach, that law enforcement alone cannot do it, but the men and women of the New Orleans Police Department continue to show up time and time and time again through the crises relative to public safety, but even as it relates to any challenges or crises that we faced as a city. Our men and women of New Orleans Public Police Department have showed up, and they don't change from one crisis to the next. They're the same men and women that continue to show up, and they deserve our support and our respect. And we have to collectively push for accountability so that individuals who are arrested and that are wreaking havoc on the streets of the city of New Orleans are held accountable for those actions, and they have consequences. And we need to ensure that those consequences, that they do matter. And large infractions end up to being, or small infractions end up to being large ones. And we want to stop them where they happen, whether small as well as large. Individuals that are wreaking havoc on our streets don't allow to be on our streets. Arrests are being made. We need to ensure that they stay off our streets. And we see the impacts. When the bad guys are off the streets, we see the results immediately. And we also see when they return, how we see those results immediately. We have to keep them away, keep them off our streets.